Hello, good afternoon to all of you, and thank you for coming in such a large numbers to welcome Comrade Yousuf Tarigami into Delhi. He is the first politician from Kashmir to have, from Srinagar, to have been permitted to come here, as I was the first political leader permitted to go to and enter Srinagar. So we are thankful to the Honorable Supreme Court and to the bench headed by the Honorable Chief Justice for allowing Comrade Yousuf Tarigami to come to Delhi for treatment at the AIMS in response to the permission to allow me to go and visit him and the affidavit that I had presented to the court. In response to that, this order had come, so he is here. The case is still open. We are thankful to our lawyers, our senior, Mr. Raju Ramachandran, who argued the case before the Supreme Court, the advocate on record, Shadan Farasat, who filed the writ petition, the habeas corpus writ petition, and the final order which has been circulated to you that the court has given on this second appearance of the case was that the case is kept open to finally for the court to decide and adjudicate on the validity of his detention from the 5th of August. So that is an issue that has not yet been decided by the court, so that will be open. In the affidavit that I submitted to the Supreme Court, I had stated that the situation very limited way in which I could see, in the restricted manner in which I was allowed in my movements and along with all the police escorts and all the security. But it was clear that the ground situation is completely contradictory to what the government is claiming. And the feeling, whatever little we could talk to, including the official personnel who were there accompanying me, the feeling was that the state has been insulted, that from being one state in the Union of India, it has now been reduced to two Union territories. And the fact, the manner in which this happened, and the question of what is the consequences of this, that can be are clearly visible there. These are issues that are very serious matters and are a subject matter of a separate writ petition that the CPIM has filed, and this has been filed, will be filed, it's in the process of being filed, it will be filed under Comrade Yousuf Tarigami's name, and that writ petition is challenging the entire abrogation of Article 370, the reorganization of the state of Jammu and Kashmir, apart from all the other issues that are connected with it. But one thing is for sure there, the main issue is of that of people's livelihood. It's now more than 40 days. People are unable to do any work to earn anything. And a large section of the people in Kashmir, in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, are those who work daily and earn, and on the basis of that, their family lives. But that has been completely disrupted. So people's issues are a very, very important one, the growing misery there, and nobody knows for how long this will continue. This complete breakdown of communication between each other in the valley, the government talks of saying that restored a large number of landlines, but the two landlines in his house are still down. Even from here you can't call them there. Many of our other members of our party, who landlines we try to access, we cannot reach them. So that communication gap is actually completely insulating and isolating people. And I don't know what is the answer and when that will be resolved. The other thing is there is no public transport. So people cannot move. Even if they are employed, they can't go to their jobs. And this is again causing a lot of disruption there. And there are also reports of shortages, and most importantly, shortages in the hospitals and of medicines. And very pathetic stories that are emanating, which are reported in the media. It's not as though these are new revelations by us. These have been reported in the international media, in sections of the national media. And this is a situation which we think needs to be resolved at the earliest. Now, as far as Tarigami has come here, the court has now said that he is free to move and go back to Srinagar whenever he wants to and wishes to go back, when he thinks that his health permits him to go back, which is what the order says clearly. So he's here now, there's no restrictions on his movement here. So because of that, we thought it'll be good to hear an authentic voice from Srinagar, coming out of Srinagar and speaking to all of you. So, Comrade Yousuf, you can...
Thank you very much. I'm grateful of all of you that you have made it convenient for us, for me to meet all of you here this afternoon. And I'm grateful to my very, very dear comrade, Comrade Sitaram, Yechury, who relentlessly fought the battle for my survival and my treatment and my coming to Delhi and providing me an opportunity to meet friends like you here. And then I must be grateful to the Honorable Supreme Court and the team of the lawyers who have permitted me to be, to enjoy moments of freedom here in the capital of my country, the country of all of us, many of us. See, I must tell you, I must take this opportunity, I am really very disturbed. We have seen difficult times in Kashmir. We have seen Kashmir remaining disturbed for a longer period, since 90 itself. There has been destruction, deaths and all that we have been witnessing. But telling you the truth, my own feelings, I have seen even the worst days, even when we got lost our friends, my family members, and attacks on my person, I was not so disturbed as I am feeling today. The reason is that I see with my own eyes feeling, a strong feeling emerging within me. Could it ever would have been possible to see such a horrible time? I am posing this question to myself. When I see myself that the very foundations of the unity of the people of Jammu and Kashmir with the Union of India are getting assaulted by those who are mandated to protect those very foundations of the Constitution. It's a big surprise for me. Rather, I feel shocked about it. We were not having much expectations from today's regime, but nevertheless, I as a citizen was never thinking of that they will be so much desperate that with one go, you will say goodbye to those constitutional provisions which were negotiated by the leaders of Jammu and Kashmir with the founders of the Constitution of India here in Delhi, which was a result of a long and protracted struggle in Kashmir as well, when the raiders came, people resisted, when Maharaja Hari Singh was himself vacillating whether to join Indian Union or not. But the people of Kashmir, despite all odds, decided not to accept the dictates from the other side, but to join secular India. They were not forced. They were not compelled. Rather, it was out of the sense, out of those values which were between the two movements of Kashmiri people who fought against autocracy and the rest in the country who fought against British rule. Today, those bonds which were created by the very hard work of the people of Kashmir and the rest of the country, the leadership there, here, those have been assaulted. I am worried about that fact. No consultation, no discussion, no debate. That's why, as a citizen, just a concerned citizen, I want to talk to through you, the citizens of my country. Whichever part they are, whichever politics they belong to, including those who are followers of today's party, which is in authority in Delhi. I want to appeal to all of them as citizens. Please listen to us. You have listened one version. Please listen to the version of the people of Kashmir as well. We don't want to be killed. We don't want to be died, seen to be destroyed. We are now, Farooq Abdullah and all others are not terrorists now. Tarigami has not turned to be an alien element for my country. I am not a foreigner. Now, I have paid price for that and I am proud of that. Ye nahi ki maine kisi par ehsaan kiya, not at all. That was my duty, I did that. Lekin aaj mera ye sawal hai. Hame bhi saath lekar chalo. Aur kuch nahi hum maangte. Ek average Kashmiri koi kuch nahi maangta, aasman ke taare nahi maangta. We don't ask for heavens. We just want, give us the chance to march with you. Hum 2016 mein, jab 2016 mein mass unrest tha Kashmir mein, opposition parties, jisme sari political parties opposition ki, मिले हम ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर से मोदी साहब से. मैंने तब भी कहा हालात बहुत खराब हैं, संभालना है. और ये जो हमारा पहरेदार है फौजी सिपाही, ये उसकी जिम्मेदारी नहीं है, क्योंकि ये उसकी करनी नहीं है. उसने हालात खराब नहीं किए. उसके कंधों पर ये बोझ मत डालिए प्राइम मिनिस्टर. ये हालात खराब हैं, ये हमारी करनी है जो इस कमरे में बैठे हैं हम सब पॉलिटिशियंस. ये सियासी दर्द है, सियासी गलतियों की वजह से इसका हल निकालना है आपकी लीडरशिप में, इसी कमरे के अंदर. और कहा कैसे, मैंने कहा अपनाइए कश्मीरियों को, कश्मीरियों को अपनाइए. और कहा अपनाने के लिए क्या करना है, मैंने कहा बात कीजिए. मैं ज्यादा आपका वक्त नहीं ले लूंगा हमारे लीडर हैं माय लीडर जनरल सेक्रेटरी ही विल एक्सप्लेन ऑल अदर इश्यूज माय पॉइंट इज नाउ यू सी एज वी आर लिविंग इन दिस वर्ल्ड आज 40 दिन हो गए क्लैंप डाउन के एंड यू आर सेटल हमारे कान ये सुनते हैं कि नॉर्मल सी हैं दिल्ली में आजमाइए और किसी शहर में आप आजमाइए अगर 7 दिन आपका इंटरनेट बंद रहे टेलीफोन बंद रहे हालत क्या होगी बिजनेस कहाँ पहुंचेगी बच्चों का क्या हाल होगा अस्पतालों का क्या हाल होगा और फिर मीडिया का क्या हाल होगा और फिर भी हमें ये कहते हैं हम कहते हैं कि भाई आज दुकान खुले नहीं स्कूल खुले नहीं अस्पतालों में जो इंश्योरेंस हेल्थ नेशनल हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस स्कीम है कितने इस 5 अगस्त से आज तक जिनको फायदा मिला कुछ भी नहीं और फिर कहते हैं शाम को फिर भी सब ठीक है मुझे बताइए ये मंत्रा क्या है नई मंत्रा और फिर एक ही चीज कहते हैं कि कोई मरा तो नहीं अरे मर रहे हैं धीरे धीरे मर रहे हैं गुठन हो रही है वहां और इसी वजह से मेरी अपील है मेरी दरख्वास्त है आप पूरे मुल्क के आवाम से जनता से हाकिमों से मैं अपील कर लेता पता नहीं मेरी आवाज पहुंचेगी या नहीं लेकिन आम गरीब जनता से आपसे मेरी ये अपील है हम भी जीना चाहते हैं एक कश्मीरी बोल रहा है यहाँ एक हिंदुस्तानी बोल रहा है यहाँ हमें भी जिंदा रहने का मौका मिलना चाहिए ये विनती है ये बात पहुंचाइए अगर आप पहुंचा सकते हैं जनाब
वेल एज आई वाज टेलिंग यू अर्लियर द रिट दैट इज बीइंग फाइल्ड बाय कॉमरेड तारिगामी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द सीपीआईएम इन दैट रिट ऑल दीज इश्यूज हैव बीन रेज्ड All these issues have been raised on the question of the abrogation of Article 370, the reorganization of the state of Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories, and also the fact that 3 years ago, when a joint parliamentary delegation visited the valley, when at the time of those disturbances that happened, more than 100 people, 120 people's lives were lost. At that point of time, when the delegation went there, we returned and a communique was issued officially by the then Home Minister, Mr. Rajnath Singh, who was leading that delegation, where on behalf of the entire parliamentary delegation, it was two things were assured, that immediate confidence building measures will be undertaken, that is the pellet guns, usage will be stopped, and the political process of a dialogue with all the stakeholders in the valley will begin immediately to find a solution. Unfortunately, which the government will have to answer by why for 3 years this assurance that the government itself had given was not implemented. And then comes this sudden move of abrogating Article 370 after the withdrawal by the BJP from the coalition government, the government falls and then there's governor's rule, but the assembly is kept alive. When there was a possibility of an alternate government emerging in the same assembly, that assembly is dissolved, all authority given to the governor, and the governor is treated as a substitute to the elected assembly of a state, and that way and through that, Article 3 of the Constitution, which says that any changes in the boundaries of any state will have to have the prior approval of the elected assembly, that was bypassed, and instead of the elected assembly, it was the governor who was treated as the elected state assembly, and then whatever followed in the parliament. Now, this entire procedure we have questioned in the writ. That is being processed and filed, and the Honorable Court has fixed up the first week, I think, of October for hearing all these writ petitions. So that will be taken up, And second, the other thing I would like to emphasize is that while all these matters will be taken up by these are all subject matters of the writ petition, therefore I do not wish to speak more. I'll only given you the subjects that we have taken up, because the matter will be sub judice and it won't be correct to speak on that. But the other point we want to say is that please remember, Comrade Mohammed Yousuf Tarigami has been elected for 4 times to the Assembly of JNK, and their life is for 6 years. That is 24 years. He has been an elected member of the Assembly from an area which is the worst terrorist infested. He was in the forefront of the fight against this terrorist. And that is why the people of Kulgam supported him consistently and he's been elected. So the commitment, he lost members of his own family by these terrorist attacks. So as far as the CPIM is concerned, our consistent fight against terrorism and consistent opposition to this is a matter that is non-negotiable. That is a matter that is not under any, it cannot be under any discussion, because terrorism is our country's enemy. That has to be fought and that will be fought. And we will be in the forefront fighting, losing lives, but yet getting people's support and getting elected. So that, on that there should be no second thoughts about it. But the question is, how do we now rebuild that confidence with the people of Kashmir? For that, what is the government planning? No consultation with any other political party in India, not in parliament, not in the states. How is this process of building any consensus to bring back normalcy will happen? These are issues that the government has to seriously consider. That is why in this writ that you're filing, these questions are being raised. We are very happy that a large number of very, very eminent senior advocates of the Supreme Court have come forward to take up this matter in the Supreme Court when it comes up. So we are thankful to them as well. And we will proceed and see the matter within the confines of what the judiciary tells us. And as I said, we are grateful to the Supreme Court for allowing Comrade Tarigami to be treated, of allowing Comrade Tarigami to move, and of saying that he can go back on his own free will and volition whenever he wants to return to his home. But whatever happens once he returns to his home, those are matters, the Honorable Court has said, they fall under the jurisdiction of the local courts. And when somebody pointed out, not in connection with this case, with our case, but in connection with some other case, that it is very difficult to access the JNK High Court, the Honorable Chief Justice himself came before the media and said that he will ensure that the High Court of Jammu and Kashmir will function, otherwise he himself will go there to do that. He made this as a public media thing, a media declaration. So we hope that the process of law in the state of Jammu and Kashmir will also proceed according to laid down procedures and rules and norms. And therefore we wish that normalcy is restored as earliest as possible. Thank you. This is what we had to say. If there are any questions, you can.
Mr. Yechury, what do you have to say on Farooq Abdullah's detention?
Well, we have already said that it was a very unfortunate and very wrong thing to do. I mean, this was an afterthought. In the parliament, when this discussion was going on, when the question arose saying that where is Mr. Farooq Abdullah, an elected member of the Lok Sabha from Srinagar, then the Honorable Home Minister said there is no restriction on his movement, we don't know why he did not attend. Later it turned out to be that he was under house arrest, but there was no charge against him, and because there was a habeas corpus moved, and now many are being moved after the one initiative that we had taken. Then the habeas corpus was moved. Then as an afterthought, the night before the habeas corpus was coming up for hearing, the Public Security Act was was imposed on him. So till then, from the 5th of August till that night when the PSA was imposed on him, there was no charge. That is now very clear. And the point is, this Farooq Abdullah, Omar Abdullah, Farooq's father, Sheikh Abdullah, these are the people who are the most ardent supporters of Kashmir's integration with India. And these are the people who are being, if they are treated in this way. That is why it is very difficult to gauge now how this process of return to normalcy and the unification can take place. But on that issue, we are very clear. We think that was a very, very wrong thing and a wrong step for the government of India to take. Yes. क्या हाँ बोलिए तरीका में सबको हाँ अभी अभी जाएंगे वो जब सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कहा जब वो चाहते हैं जाने के लिए अब वो समझते हैं कि वो जाने की क्षमता रखते हैं तो उस समय जा सक जाएं तो कोई पाबंदी सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने रखा नहीं अभी फिलहाल आज दिल्ली में है
नहीं इसमें मैं ही कहूँगा
जल्द से जल्द जाएंगे
मैंने आपसे नहीं पूछा कहाँ कहाँ जाएंगे वर्चुअली आ सकनी मैं श्रीनगर जाऊँगा दिल्ली जाऊँगा अपने मुल्क के हर जगह पर जाऊँगा और अब सिर्फ यही है कि आप भी मेरी मदद करें दुआ करें क्या आना जाना रहे वही तो हम चाहते हैं तभी हम आपसे मिले हैं कि आना जाना रहना चाहिए आप भी वहाँ आ जाए हम भी यहाँ आ जाए यस ये अभी की बात है ये इसमें कहते हैं कब हुआ ये थोड़ा सा इसमें मैं जाऊँ इसमें हाँ ये आपको मालूम होगा क्या 4 तारीख शाम को फारूक अब्दुल्ला के घर में हमारी आल पार्टीज मीटिंग भी हुई थी गुपकार डिक्लेरेशन जिसमें हमने एक्सप्रेस किया था कंसर्न क्या ऐसी अफवाहें हैं क्या होना नहीं चाहिए अपील की थी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया से और ये भी हमने अपील की थी जम्मू कश्मीर के आवाम से कि वो अमन से रहे फारूक अब्दुल्ला ने हमारी तरफ से वहाँ बोला प्रेस को उसके बाद घरों में आए चर्चा था मुख्तलिफ बातों का अफवाहें थी तो रात के 12 बजे हमें इतला दी गई कि घरों से वैसे बाहर नहीं आ सकते और मैंने उससे कहा जिसने मुझे कहा मैंने उससे कहा कि वैसे मेरा इरादा इस वक्त घर से बाहर जाने का नहीं है तो इंतज़ार कीजिए कल तक क्या होता है तो उसके मुताबिक 5 तारीख की मिडनाइट से ही हमें घरों से बाहर न निकलने का हुक्म दिया गया रोका गया और इसी वजह से हमारे सीताराम याचुरी साहब ने आंध्रप्रदेश सुप्रीम कोर्ट से रजू किया कि हमें बताइए वायर अबाउट्स कहाँ हैं तारीगामी के और फिर ये बताइए कि वजह क्या है कि वो बाहर नहीं आ सकता वो हम कोई उससे मिल नहीं सकता वो अभी पेंडिंग है उसका फैसला कर लेगी आंध्रप्रदेश सुप्रीम कोर्ट लेकिन फिलहाल ये अपॉर्चुनिटी नसीब हुई है इनकी कोशिशों से आंध्रप्रदेश सुप्रीम कोर्ट से जिसका हम शुक्रगुजार हैं
No, the point is that the government has given its version. I have told you that what the government is claiming is the ground reality is completely contradictory to it. These are matters that will come up when the writ petition is taken up for consideration. They are all there in the writ petition that we have been filed, and these are once it's admitted, once it's a public document, you'll come to know about all those things. But the reality on the ground and what the government is claiming are something that just do not match.
Besides,
those who are
You see, besides that, what the जो अभी आपने फरमाया कि सब कुछ ठीक है और एक बुलेट भी नहीं चला, वैसे वो जेलों में भी कोई बुलेट नहीं चलता है तो जेल जेल भी होता है. हमें एक चीज़ बताइए, हमें डिप्राइव क्यों किया जाता है जो फैसिलिटीज़ एक सिटीज़न को पूरे देश के अंदर है, टेलीफोन की, इंटरनेट की, वो तो रेस्टोर क्यों नहीं होती? उनसे सिर्फ यही पूछ लीजिए कि अभी जो हमारे स्कूल हैं, कॉलेजेस हैं, जो अभी वहाँ सबसे बड़ी इंडस्ट्री फ्रूट की, वो एक हिस्सा तो उसका ख़राब हो गया, बाजार को पहुँचे नहीं, और अभी बड़ा हिस्सा पड़ा है, क्या हाल होगा उसका? लाइवलीहुड के इश्यूज़ जो हैं उनका क्या बना? ये एफिडेविट का सवाल नहीं है, ये सिर्फ कहने की बातें नहीं है. हम तो सिर्फ ये गुजारिश कर लें जो मैंने ये भी कहा, ट्रीट एवरेज कश्मीरी एज ए सिटीज़न. और उस ऐनक से आप भी देख लीजिए कि वहाँ जो हो रहा है, क्या एक सिटीज़न के साथ, एक कम्युनिटी ऑफ पीपल के साथ ऐसा होना चाहिए? हमारी नज़र में ऐसा नहीं हो, वही बेहतर है.
The other thing is, the government had ordered in the last time on this case, in the habeas corpus case, had given a notice to the government. The Supreme Court had given the notice to the government to answer to the notice in a period of 7 days and fix the date that was fixed for yesterday. But the government has not given its answer. That's why the case is pending. It's waiting for the government to determine whether he's actually was under detention or no. No, first of all, the first time when I went there on the 9th of August, they did not even hand over the letter that I had written from the airport for Comrade Yousuf Tarigami, which they promised that they will hand it over to him when I was not allowed to enter Srinagar. The second time we went on the 24th, and after that the letter written to the President of India, there is no reply so far. The various correspondence we had with the Honorable Governor of Jammu and Kashmir, now I don't know whether it's still called that to the governor, there's no response. So we've not got any response for anything. The question of restoring normalcy and national interests, these are issues of definition between the government and the honorable courts. Normalcy is the people also normalcy. People's lives have to be normal. That is the basis of normalcy. And that normalcy is naturally, as I told you earlier, which is part of my affidavit that I submitted, that normalcy has been disrupted because the daily life has been disrupted. So what is normalcy and what is the national interest, the threats to national interest? These are assessments that the government of the day will have to give, and it's for the Honorable Supreme Court to see whether the arguments the government gives are valid or not. Yeah, this is an issue. This is an issue. I'm sorry. No, it's not that I don't want to answer this issue, but this is not the occasion when we are talking about entirely some other matter. We'll definitely answer that separately.
So people will be asked, Comrade Sitaram, sir, the Prime Minister has said that the Desh Sardar Patel ki ke jo sapne the, ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat, usko saakar hote hue dekh raha hai, jo azadi ke samay se adhura tha. Aaj Prime Minister ka hi bayan.
Yes, सरदार पटेल के मौजूदगी में ये धारा 370 को लागू करवाने के लिए, जोड़ने के लिए हमारे संविधान में निर्णय हुआ. सरदार पटेल उस समय गृहमंत्री थे और उनकी पूरी सहमति के साथ जो भी हुआ कश्मीर के साथ वो हुआ. अब इतिहास को ही तोड़ मरोड़ कर पेश करें तो अब क्या बताएं? ये सब हमारे इतिहास के किताबों में है, आपके कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली डिबेट्स के अंदर है, और वो जहाँ पर क्रूशियल मीटिंग होती है शेख अब्दुल्ला और नेहरू और सरदार के साथ, वो क्रूशियल मीटिंग के अंदर जो ये तय हुआ, वही जो हुआ फाइनली धारा 370 के बारे में, वही हुआ जिसकी उनकी पूरी स्वीकृता और अनुमति रही। अब ये उल्टा तोड़ मरोड़ कर पेश करते इतिहास को अपने राजनीति के हिसाब से, ये जो है जो हो रहा गलत। Well, that we'll have to see. Will terrorist movement get aggravated? That we'll have to see. I mean, the other side.
Nay, my own experience is, you see, the question, the real problem in Kashmir has been that is the deficit, trust deficit. There has been a lot of alienation, and which we have been, as our General Secretary has been telling, that was our effort, that there should be a process, credible process of dialogue. And only then we can reduce that alienation, restore confidence among the larger sections of the population. And that is how you can isolate those elements who want to indulge in violence, who want to use in violence as an instrument to destabilize the atmosphere in Kashmir. That's what our opinion has been. But in my opinion, what today, on 5th of August, what has happened, how the very aspirations of the people of Jammu and Kashmir, how, I must put it a little more sharply, how the people of Jammu and Kashmir have been humiliated, that does not create confidence, that reduces whatever little was available there, and that can only oblige those who want to destabilize further Kashmir situation, who want to have more alienation in Kashmir, who want to have more turmoil in Kashmir. That's very unfortunate. To say, to sum it up, virtually such moves have provided fodder to the forces who want to encourage violence in Kashmir.
Louder.
Those who are giving a different version of Kashmir are people who are going to the line of Pakistan. How do you see that statement?
Tarigami.
Yes.
Those who are not agreeing with the government version of Kashmir are saying that you are helping Pakistan.
We are helping
Pakistan.
We are. Oh. Wonderful. Mere sahab, aaj tak अभी आज बताइए कि कांग्रेस की रिजीम रही है यहाँ यूपीए की, वहाँ इनकी सरकारें रही, अभी मोदी साहब का पार्ट फर्स्ट यहाँ सरकार रही और वहाँ उनकी सांझी सरकार रही, और सांझी सरकार में ये था कि 2014 में जब पार्लियामेंट का असेंबली का चुनाव हुआ, इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया का वेबसाइट देख लीजिए और आपको पता चलेगा कितना एंथुसियाज्म था लोगों में वोट में पार्टिसिपेट करने के लिए। और जब महबूबा मुफ्ती पार्लियामेंट की मेंबर नहीं रही, चीफ मिनिस्टर बनी, फिर मिड टर्म पोल एक पार्लियामानी कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी में कंडक्ट किया गया, दिल्ली में मोदी साहब थे और जम्मू कश्मीर में बीजेपी पीडीपी थी, बीच रास्ते में ही प्रोसेस को रोक दिया गया इलेक्शन का। ऐसा दम था सरकारों में कि एक कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी में वो चुनाव नहीं कर पाए। मेरा एक सवाल है उनसे, वक्त के हाकिमों से, 2014 में कितने मिलिटेंट थे कश्मीर में, और फिर 2015, 16, 17, 18 में ये गिनती कहां पहुंच गई? कैसे टैकल किया ये सिचुएशन को? इनके सवाल, ऐसे सवालात का जवाब आजकल मिलता नहीं है। ये आज भी मेरा ये सवाल है, आज मिलिटेंसी को काबू किया जा सकता है लोगों के मदद से, लोगों के ताउन से। मैं आपसे ये सवाल करना चाहता हूँ, क्या लोगों की पिटाई करके, लोगों को जेल में बंद करके, इंटरनेट टेलीफोन लाइंस ऑफ करके, रोज़मर्रा जिंदगी को ठप करके क्या लोगों में विश्वास पैदा किया जा सकता है? या और ये माहौल किनके हक में जाएगा? देश के दुश्मनों को खुश कर लेगा या देशवासियों में एतमाद पैदा कर लेगा? ये सवाल आपके सामने है और देश के सामने मैं रखना चाहता हूं।
Otherwise, the point is only when the people are united can you fight terrorism, can you fight cross-border terrorism, can you fight what Pakistan is doing. It is that unity that has to be strengthened. And as I told you, he has lost members of his own family. He comes from the place where, which is the worst according to the Home Ministry, the area that is the worst terrorist infested, and yet he gets the people's support and wins. What does that mean? If we talk about the Kashmiri people, you say that he is pro-Pakistan. His whole political life has been fighting Pakistan and fighting terrorism.
And not only, sir, main ye add kar lunga, not only me, can you imagine? You have a lot many people there who were earlier participants in the government of central governments. Umar was once foreign minister. जूनियर फॉरेन मिनिस्टर इन वाजपेयी साहब टाइम, तब तो ठीक था। महबूबा वाज पटना, तब तो ठीक था। और आज वो सारे लोग जेल में हैं, तालियां बजा रहे हैं सरहद पार से, मरहबा दिल्ली वालों, जो हम न कर पाए वो आप कर रहे हैं। फारूक अब्दुल्ला को पब्लिक सेफ्टी एक्ट में अपने ही घर में एक कमरे में बंद रखना, कमाल की सियासत है। ये देश के हक में है, मैं देशवासियों के अदालत में और अदालत में नहीं, इसीलिए मैं यहाँ आया हूँ आपकी वसातत से, मैं अदालत में, देश की अदालत में रखना चाहता हूँ। जो आज हो रहा है वहाँ कश्मीर में, वो मुल्क के हित में नहीं हो रहा है, देश के हित में नहीं हो रहा है।
ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच।